First of all, I would like to say how proud we are as DIE to be co-hosts of these development and climate days. And I would also like to express deep thanks and appreciation to Salim Book, who organized, who founded these development and climate days and showed great vision on the deep connections between these two policy areas. And maybe you all want to give him a big clap of hands. I think what these days show is that climate policy and development cannot be dissociated. This sounds very trivial, but many of you, I assume, are from organizations where you know that these connections, you have to explain them, you have to defend them to the broader constituencies of your organization all the time. Because in our world, most policy processes and most knowledge processes are dissociated, are specialized. And this is, let's say, the traditional way of organizing efficient and effective policy ways. But then we don't look at the connections and we don't look at interdependencies. And I think we know that decarbonization of production and consumption, the ultimate goal of climate policy, interferes with everything we do. It interferes with the social fabric of our lives. And it interferes with what we think or take for granted. The same is true with advancing global warming. It attacks the basis of our, threats the basis of our lives. It asks completely new questions, how to preserve livelihoods or find new ones. And I think it's these insights that the development and climate days are based on and expressed in the choice of their four main themes, which we will hear more about in the plenary session in a few minutes. So resilience through empowerment and access, valuing lived experience and local knowledge, transparency and downward accountability, and shared resilience in an interconnected world. I think these four main themes express the deep outreach of the transformation process we think is absolutely unavoidable. And it also expresses the difficulties and the opportunities in finding new knowledge bases and new visions for a livable future, but also the need for international cooperation and for solidarity. If this is not based, if our action is not based on that, I think we won't be successful. So I think the development and climate days are moving up from being a meeting place of development and climate people to being an influential partnership of organizations committed to achieving the Paris ambition, global ambition, also through local action, but through cooperation, through sharing knowledge and experience. Here, I think we have the chance to address topics under negotiation here in Bonn and bring evidence and experience into them. And I think the development and climate days also nicely take up the Talanoa spirit of the Fiji presidency, which I hope will also contribute to further negotiations. Finally, we from my institute, from the German Development Institute, appreciate the COP23 focus on vulnerability, as it underscores the need to connect the dots between climate action, sustainable development policies, and humanitarian action. Interconnections are at the center of our work. I mentioned the interconnection zone, and I would like to invite you to visit it. We appreciate it very much that we can support the development and climate days in our hometown. When do you have a COP in your hometown? This is a great thing to have you all here. It makes a difference if you come for the intersessionals or if you come for the COP, actually. And it makes us very happy to be able to contribute to our joint thinking and action for a just transformation. Thank you.